we'll look into the concept of segmentation. It's a memory management scheme which supports the user view of memory. A program is a collection of segment. A segmentation is a logical segment is a logical unit, such as we are breaking it into logically as main program, procedure, function, method, object, variable, block, stack, symbol, table, array, likewise. And this is how a user's view of a program is, right? Subroutine is written, main program is the square root is a built-in function, stack is used, it is making use of a symbol table. This is what we have a look on our program. And logical view of user space, we have broken up into four parts. These four might be located somewhere on the physical memory. This is how we think of logical address. So based on the same view, we can also have a memory allocation scheme. So here what we are doing is the CPU generated address, that is nothing but a logical address, is again divided into two parts, that is segment number and offset. In paging, we had a page number, here we have a segment number, that is the difference. Again, instead of a page table, we are making use of a segment table. Here it is used to map the two-dimensional physical addresses. We know that logical address is generated by CPU and which has to be actually mapped to a logical address by main memory in order to access the main memory rate, that what we call as MMU. That segment table is also having a base and limit. Base contains the starting physical address for that particular segment which resides in the memory. Limit specifies the length of that particular segment. So again, similar to page table, we require a segment table base register and segment table length register indicating the length of the segment used by the program. So segment number S is legal if it is lesser than the segment table length register. So segmentation architecture continued here. Again, we can also have a protection of this similar to a paging, where validation bit can be used which is set with a 0. It is valid invalid. Again, we can have read write execution privileges similar to that of that paging. One thing that you can observe here is protection bits are associated with the segments. Code sharing occurs here at the segment level. Segments are of varying length because we are breaking up the program into based on user's view. So the different modules of the program are of different sizes. So segmentation example we'll see here. So this is our segmentation hardware. As you can observe, CPU generated logical address is divided into S and D rather than P and D, and limit and base registers are used. Limit is that offset should be always lesser than the limit of that. Then if it is true, then we are adding the base of that to the offset to find the effective address on the physical memory. If the offset is larger than the limit, larger than the length of that particular segment, then it is leading to an addressing error trapped by the OS. Sharing of pages we have seen. Similarly, we have sharing of segments also. You can see we have two processes, process P1 and process P2. Segment 0 is storing the editor, which is commonly shared by both the processes here and here. The private data is stored here in the segment 1 of process 1, and in segment 1 of process 2, its private data is stored. And the segment table for process P1 looks like this. At 0, it is having a maximum length of 25286. It starts with the base as 43062. First segment is stored as 4425, base is 68348. As you can observe, that editor is started loading at 68348, started at 43062. And when you add 25286 to this, you'll get the 68348. This is where the base of the segment 1 starts, isn't it? And here it is having a length of 4425, that is the limit is 4425. When we add this, we are going to get it as 72773. This is where the segment 1 is allocated with the memory. Similarly, segment table of process P2 you can also the same is shared by both of this, right? First segment, that is 0th segment, is having a limit same, base same, it's commonly shared by both of this. Data 2 of this is present at segment 1, which is having a limit of 8850 and base is starting with 90003. So 9003 is a base of this. Add 8850 to this, that will be a last address which can be accessible by process P2 for that particular segment. So that is where the data 2 is stored in the physical memory for it. So that's all about segmentation. So in next class I'll take certain problems in order to map the logical address to physical address. Thank you.